I, right?
I'm not going to bite my face off.
I know.
Okay. Bailey. Good girl. Some good things, some really good things that are happening is even though she's aroused, if she's responsive. When we first came out, we had to go way far away, but here we've kind of chaperoned this approach. Bailey. Doing, which allows us to get closer, because I read her as, let me go meet that dog.
Right.
I need to say to her, you will never meet that dog when we're pulling, when we're going, you know, when we're aroused and out of control. Instead, if you can check in with me, or if you can at least not pull, then I will consider moving you in. Okay.
So when she's loose on the leash and checking in, that's
well, I mean, I'm going way too fast here,
right.
But I don't have, you know, I mean,
yeah.
We would spend a week out there and working at a distance because I want that look in to be much more reliable. If I call her now, I have to really kind of give energy and magnetism to get her off. I want to be able to call her Bailey and have her head snap around and then
okay.
be on me, but she's barely acknowledging me. Yeah.
So we know what to do.
When you can, so with this kind of training, when you can control the environment, so we know no other dog is going to run up to us and scare us and get in the way, the longer you do this, the more therapeutic it is. If I was going to Petco, it would be short, sweet, get me in, get me out, let the dog have a rest, then go in, short, sweet, and come out. But here, the longer we're here, the more she starts looking like a dog. The less like a wild animal.
Right.
Okay. Come here, Bailey. She's just a reactive dog. She's under socialized.